We come into the mew in the morning and the red tails fluff and kind of some. And she goes. She's very vocal. She's been great this week, and I don't know if it's the weather or what, but she's had a great attitude. And being that I am a short female, she doesn't care to be held by me. And if she's not in a good mood, I really know it. So I really, really know it. One year, I have to tell a story. One year, we were up here, and some trout fishermen caught a whole mess of trout, a whole bunch of trout, and they gave us some trout. They said, eagle, fish eagle, you know, right? And she would not eat that trout. She would rather, it's like if we were supposed to eat the carpet on this floor, she would not eat it. Ashley even had to open it up with his knife. And she wouldn't have anything to do with it. Excuse me, I have microphone confusion. Aww. And that's because her favorite food, contrary to eagles in the wild, are big white rats, which we eat at the zoo. And that is a sure sign that she's overfed because she could refuse food, which was the trout. But we found it very amusing that she wouldn't eat the food that she's known to eat, that eagles are known to eat. Does that feel good, Ashley? No? Her wingspan is about 6.5 feet long, wide. Now, we got her, she was part of a hacking program through Game and Fish, and hacking is when the biologist will take an egg from an eagle nest, which typically have two or three. Not every eaglet is going to survive. So they'll take an egg and they'll hatch it themselves, and they will raise it with minimal human intervention, making certain it's fed and healthy and whatnot, and then it will release itself into the wild. Well, Lynn was in a hacking program and was out on the platform and had the food and whatnot when she was about 1.5 years old. Young eagles, like young teenagers, don't fly well. Teenagers don't drive well, although Wendy and Ashley say, I don't drive well, but that's another story. They don't drive well. Their wings are about 7 of her wings. And if you look at her, she droops just a bit. Her wings droop just a bit. They tried to repair it, but they couldn't. She will never be able to be released into the wild because of it. I've tried to tell a serious story and she's biting you. I love it. I love it. But nonetheless, she's a beautiful bird and she is the flagship of our program here. This is Lynn, the bald eagle. There was an article, and the headline was, Barn Owls Unite Israelis and Jordanians. And because of the constant warfare and lack of education in some areas in the Middle East, the rampant use of pesticides has decimated the bird population in the Middle East. So rodents run wild. Rodents spread disease. Rodents eat the food. It's a huge, terrible problem for public health. Now, the Israelis have reintroduced, they stopped the use of pesticides, and they have reintroduced barn owls. And they are so effective that the rodent population is dwindling because of that. The neighboring country of Jordan, similar huge problem, but is faced with religious paradigms and political problems, and the natural enemy, the Israelis are the enemies, but they are desperate for a solution. So they have contacted the Israelis to study the barn owl, to see if they too can use the barn owl to save their food supply and to get rid of the rodents. Now I want to tell that story because our focus is conservation and birds of prey. And while it's probably true, I think it's fair to say that economics will probably be that which turns the tide for conservation and saving birds of prey. And what a win that would be if a raptor, like a barn owl, can overcome politics.
Okay. Thank you.